To beat Portal 2's cooperative campaign, you have to beat all the 5 courses, right? Well, not exactly. You see, the cooperative campaign has the hub map, where you navigate between the courses. Once you beat course 1, you gain access to course 2, and once you beat course 2, you gain access to course 3, and so on. Well, that's at least how you're supposed to do it. What if you're a speedrunner, where the laws of physics merely become suggestions? Is it possible to bypass these course restrictions? Let's see how speedrun world record holders complete Portal 2 co-op. So, how exactly is it possible for speedrunners to skip courses in Portal 2 co-op? Well, when you unlock a course normally, nothing too special happens. The door in the hub is simply unlocked, and it will open when you approach it. However, that door is the only thing prohibiting us from accessing a new course. Even if we don't have that course unlocked, we can see that the elevators are still here, and the game lets us enter the first level. So, as long as we find a way to get into the room with the disassembly station, we can access the course, even without beating the previous courses normally required. But this is easier said than done, as getting into this room is really, really hard. Normally, you'd expect that we could do some out-of-bounds shenanigans, but out-of-bounds tricks are almost exclusively found in the single-player game, mainly because of saving and loading glitches. Since you can't save and load in co-op, out-of-bounds tricks are very hard to come by. So for this skip, we're going to set our sights on the Course 3 room, as if we were to skip straight into Course 3, we would skip Courses 1 and 2. This adds up to approximately 40% of the game. Why Course 3, you may ask? Well, under the disassembly station, there's a small room, with no renderable textures, no doors, no... nothing. This room is essentially the Source Engine equivalent of Purgatory. So when it comes to skipping courses in Portal 2 co-op, why would a peculiar room like this be helpful? Well, the robots can actually place portals on this weird, non-rendered texture, and getting a portal into this room would get us right below the disassembly stations. This is incredibly valuable when it comes to breaking into the course. However, we're still far from the goal. Luckily for speedrunners and glitch hunters, we have access to a plethora of glitches, so let's see which glitches can help us get into this room. The quantum crouch is a glitch that's kind of similar to Schrödinger's famous thought experiment, the Schrödinger's cat. Basically, we're going to put the player into a state where they are both crouched and uncrouched at the same time. Why exactly is this helpful? Well, there's a couple of differences between being crouched and uncrouched. The biggest is the player's hitbox. When you're crouched, your hitbox becomes smaller, and you can fit into smaller places. However, a fun fact regarding hitboxes is that Chell doesn't actually shoot portals out of the portal gun. They technically come out of the player's camera, aka Chell's eyes. So yeah, if you thought Superman's laser eyes were cool, imagine Chell shooting literal wormholes out of her eyes. This hitbox distinction is important, because when Chell crouches, her camera goes downward with her hitbox. The quantum crouch allows us to keep the player's camera in a standing position, even though the player is crouched. So, to achieve the quantum crouch, the player has to enter a floor-to-wall portal at a 90-degree angle, and crouch at a specific time. As a result of faulty floor-to-wall camera correction, the player will be in a quantum crouch state. Are they crouched? Are they uncrouched? Really, it's both. Now, the player's collision hitbox is in a crouched state, but the player's camera, where they shoot portals from, is in a standing state. To clarify, walls and ceilings think that we are crouching, but our portal gun thinks that we are standing. This means that if we bonk our head on a ceiling, the player's camera will actually go through the ceiling, so a portal can be placed into this room. But I have to back up for a second, because with Quantum Crouch, we now know that we can get a portal into this purgatory room if we're underneath it. But how exactly can we get underneath this obscure room in the first place? The reportal glitch is exactly what we need in this situation. Essentially, if a player is standing inside of a portal, and a new, connecting portal is placed, the player will get pushed out of the portal. This is an intended mechanic used to stop the player from reaching sneaky angles with the portal gun. However, speedrunners can use this intended portal behavior to their advantage. If a player is going through a floor portal, the player can reshoot the portal they are going into on a nearby wall. If the timing is correct, the player will receive a push out of the portal and receive extra height as a result of the boost. This is a reportal, and we can perform reportals indefinitely to gain seemingly infinite height. Using the reportal glitch, the robots can easily maneuver their way underneath the third course's disassembly station. After entering the lobby, one of the robots can get into a quantum crouch state, and then use these super small portal surfaces to hit 5 reportals and fly up to the top of the lobby. Then, the player can crawl along the edge of the chamber's bounds until landing on a lower platform to shoot a portal into the so-called Purgatory Room. Then, their partner will replace the newly placed secret portal, as the player will now die in order to reunite with the other robot. Now, with the two robots together, and the sneaky portal placed under the disassembly station, we can attempt to clip into the course room. With another quantum crouch, the player can shoot a portal into the final room. However, this room is much taller than our previous clip, so we're gonna need to get some extra height. Thankfully, with some acrobatics, we can make a robot tower. With good balance and some portal shenanigans, we can use our partner as a stool. Once stacked, a portal replacement will give a brief period for the player to shoot a portal into the disassembly room. Once the portal shot lands, the duo has successfully breached into the third course, and can progress without completing the team building or mass and velocity courses. This skip ends up saving almost 8 minutes in Portal 2 co-op, and it is essentially the biggest sequence break in any Portal speedrun. As a result of this game-changing skip, a speedrunning category split was created on the leaderboards. Portal 2 speedrunners can either run all main courses, where they have to complete all courses 1 through 5, or any percent, where this insane skip is utilized. So, with some precise acrobatics, a touch of quantum physics theory, and a pair of portal guns, speedrunners can skip almost half of Portal 2 co-op. Well, anyways, I have to go. Oh wait, the rest of this video does require some explanation. Let me give you the fast version. There! If you have any questions, just remember what I said in slow motion. Watch on your own recognizance. I'll be right back.